Welcome back. In this tutorial, we will learn how to create 3D model in AutoCAD 2015. We want to create this model. Click on Start Drawing. Then, now here only 2D commands are available. For 3D commands, click on this arrow near the gear icon and click on 3D modeling. So, it will show the 3D commands. Now here X and Y is visible. To view the Z axis, click on this unsaved view, AC isometric. And to remove this XYZ, give the UCS icon command. Enter no origin. Select the no origin option. Now in this object, at first we want to create this sketch. So this sketch is on the front plane. If you want to create something on this surface, you have to choose the front plane. If you want to create something on this surface, you have to choose the right plane. So at first I will choose front plane. So from this word, click on the front. So X, Y become vertical and Z become horizontal. Now choose the line command to create the shape. So we want to create this shape. So it is 24. Then 10, 52, again 24. So take the line command, give the first point, ortho on, make ortho on for straight line, give the distance of 24. Enter, zoom minus, pan it or zoom all, Z enter, A enter. Then again line command. From here I want to go up by 10. Again from this side up to 52. Again below by 10. And again by 24. Enter. So again give zoom all. Okay. Then now there is the thickness is of 12. So we'll offset it by 12. So as these lines are separate, so we will convert into a single line by using join command. So click on modify, join, and select all the object, enter. Now this object becomes single object, so we will offset it. So click on offset. So here is the offset command, offset, give distance of 12, enter, select the object, give the side, upper side, click, escape to come out. Then select the end points from this end point to this end point, enter to repeat the command, enter to come out. Then to convert this into a 3D object, and we will have to give a depth of 160. For that we will use presspull. So click on presspull, go inside the shape, give the direction and give the distance of 160, enter, escape, zoom all. So zoom all will reset the limits every time and it will increase the limit. To view in 3D visual style, click on this 2D wireframe and click on shaded. And make the grids off so you can view the object clearly. So now this bottom portion is ready. Then I want to create this portion. So for that I will choose a right plane. So click here and take the right plane. Now here the circle radius is 30. So this length will be 60 and we already created this 12 height. That means the height from here it will be 30. 42 minus 12. That means we will create 60, 30. So take the line command. Give the first point. Give direction. So here 60. Upside. We will need it. 30. Again here 60. Escape. On this direction 60 and close it here, enter. Now here we need a circle, of 30 radius. So click on, suppose we will use arc, click on arc. So we have start point, center point and end point. So click on start point, center point and end point. So this arc is created. Then we will need one more circle inside, 30 diameter, 15 radius. So for that click on circle, click the midpoint and give the radius of 50. Then we don't need this line, so erase it, give E enter, select the object, enter. Now the thickness is 76, so we will again press pull, select this surface, give the direction and thickness is 76, enter, press escape. Then this object we will have to keep here, so for that we will use move, select object, enter, give this as a base point and give this point as a end point. So this object is created properly. Then next will be to create this reapportion. So the total length is 160 from here and minus this 60, that means 100 from here. So to create this rib, we will create one line, give L enter, and we will give length of 100 so that it will become 160. Then we will have to create one line from this end, give line from this end, click on this end point, make ortho off, we can press F8. Then I want this line tangent to this circle, so press shift and right click, leave the shift button, tangent, click on the circle, enter. Again click on press pull, take the inner portion, give the side, give the thickness of 12, escape. Then we can erase this object, we don't want this object now, enter. Now this rib we want to keep it here, place it here, so we will move it again, move, select object, enter. We will take this midpoint as a base point and this midpoint as a second point, then erase this. So in this way this object is created. The next thing will be to dimension the object in 3D. So for that, suppose I want to place dimension on this surface, so I can choose again front plane, or actually I want to dimension on this face actually, so from here I will choose face option, select this face and enter, then put the dimension. So for dimension click on annotate, then take this linear, give the first point, give the second point and location. Now it is not properly visible, to change the setting give D, enter, modify, fit, increase the scale, suppose I will make it 10, ok, close. So it is properly visible. I will change other settings also, so give D, enter, modify. Then I want lines in between the extension lines, click on primary units, make it single 0, then in text make it above, align with ISO standard, ok, close. So it is properly visible now, or I will just increase size a little bit, so modify, fit, I will make it suppose 15, enter, ok, close. So next will be the height, again linear, first point, second point, location, it is 22, actually we need this dimension of 24, so we will have to press pull this surface by 2 mm, so we will just move these two objects outside. And then go to home, press pull, select this surface, give the height, direction, place the dimension, escape. So in this way, this has become 24. This happened because this height was 10, therefore it got actually, after offsetting by 12, it becomes 22. But here we want gap more than 12, therefore we moved the surface. Then again we will move this, select this two object, select this endpoint and put it on this endpoint. So it is perfect now. We can erase this line. Enter. Okay. Then it is correct. Then next will be this dimension. Again annotate dimension. So from here to here is 12. So we will keep it here. Again dimension from here to here it is 24. Then again here to here is should be 52. Okay. And again here 24. Okay, it is alright. Then next will be the length. So for I want to create on this surface. So again click on home. From here choose the face option, select this face, press enter. Again give this total length. So again annotate dimension from this point to this point. So 160 is correct. Then next will be dimension on this surface. So again we'll take the face option, face, then select this face, enter. Then again we want to give dimension, so I want to give radius for these two circles suppose. So select from your radius, select the outside circle and give the radius here how much you want. Same for inside circle also. For this also I want to give the radius. So this radius is there. Then I want to give linear from this point to this end point. It should be 42. Yeah. Give it 42. Then so three dimension, this width and this dimension and this. Three dimensions. So the first is this one. Suppose from this end to this end. Okay, I will have to change the plane again. So home, face option, select this surface, enter. Again, annotate dimension from here to here. Give how much is 32. Again face, select on this face, enter. Now it got inclined. Again dimension from this midpoint to this point midpoint. And we want to place there only, suppose at the mid. We can view it in 2D wireframe. Okay. So it is there. Then next will be the width of this. This option on this face. Enter. Then again annotate dimension from this end point to this end point. 76. Click there. So in this way all dimension has been given. So that's all. This 3D model is ready with dimensions. So we will stop here. Thanks for watching the video.